took a shower and I'm trying to air dry my hair. Hello YouTube friends and welcome to So Aldo. Today on So Aldo Style, I am going to talk to you about the clothes that I don't wear as a petite girl. So if you are intrigued, be sure to stay tuned. Before we get started, be in the know, subscribe to my channel, and be notified. I post 4 videos every week. With that being said, let's go ahead and get started. So like I mentioned earlier, today I am going to talk to you about clothes that I don't wear or stop wearing as a petite size. So number one on my list is anything that is low rise. Anything low rise will not complement a petite size body. The reason why is my torso is short. If you wear a low rise jeans or waistline, the waistline is going to be really low. Therefore, it's going to make the legs shorter and the torso longer. So the proportion is way off. In the most part, low-rise jeans doesn't look good on anyone. That's my own opinion. If you like low-rise jeans and if you're not a petite, you go ahead, do whatever, wear whatever you want. But if you're a petite, I will suggest to stay away from low-rise anything just because it will look awkward and the proportion is not right. Number two on my list is high and low hemlines. So I actually just recently stopped wearing high and low hemlines just because I noticed it just doesn't look good on me. The reason why is just because if the hemline is like right at the knee, it actually cuts me off right there and it makes me look like I have little legs. Number three on my list, drop waist dresses. If you don't know what drop waist dress is, the waistline is like, you know, it's not on the normal area. It's going to be like at least like on the bum area. I think it's just dropped. So it's basically a shapeless dress. The reason why I don't wear those type of garments is the same as the low rise jeans or anything low rise. It's not going to complement my look. It's gonna make my legs shorter and my torso longer, and then the proportion is way off. I like to stay away from any drop waist dresses at all cost just because it is not going to complement my petite size. It's going to make me look even shorter because the waistline is dropped to almost to the bum area, so it basically lowers your legs. It makes your legs stubbier and shorter. I don't own any drop waist garments in my closet. Okay, so number four is big prints. So I don't own any big massive prints. So as a petite size, wearing big prints will overwhelm your shape. You're gonna get lost in it and it's just not a good look. It's very awkward. The proportion is not going to be correct. Bigger prints, of course, is going to make you look bigger. Okay, number five on my list is chunky sweater. Although sometimes it is nice to have chunky sweater, feel cozy in it. It feels like you're carrying blanket everywhere you go. But I try to stay away from chunky sweaters. I just wear regular sweater. Don't like wearing chunky sweaters just because it just makes me look top heavy. That's why I try to stay away from chunky sweater at all costs. But I also try to find like sweaters that are also warm but not as super chunky. Still oversized but not chunky. So you can do that. Oversized sweater but not chunky. Chunky is like those one that are super super big and voluminous. Regular sweater will do if you are a petite size so it doesn't overwhelm your frame. So that was so easy, right? So number six on my list are wide ankle sandals. I actually just stopped doing that. I just stopped buying those wide strap sandals or ankle strap sandals. It will make your legs wider and chunkier, and plus it cuts you off. It makes you look shorter and the legs a little chunkier. So it's not just for petite size. Also, if you are a regular size, that is the same thing. If you wear wider straps, it's going to give you that illusion just because, you know, the wider straps can give that illusion you have short and stubby legs. If you want your legs to always look slim, stay away from wide ankle strap shoes or sandals. So number seven on my list is wide stripes t-shirts or garments. Same thing with a wide ankle strap. Anything that is wide stripe is going to make you look wider. That's why I try to stay away from that, just because wider stripes doesn't complement a petite frame as well. Always go for a slimmer or thinner stripe if you like. I do love stripes and I have a few, but they are very thin stripes, not the wide one. Just because for that reason, it's going to overwhelm a petite size frame. So that was easy as well. It's kind of self-explanatory. Number 8 on my list is a scoop neck anything, top, dress, anything. This is my personal choice though, just because I have a shorter torso. Imagine if I wear a scoop neck. It's basically half of my body, my upper body, and I don't feel comfortable showing that off. So, but that, if you don't have a problem with that, you know, no one is stopping you. And last but not the least is a knee-length skirt. The reason why is, first, I don't like showing my knees because they look awful. But basically, if I wear like a knee-length skirt, it cuts me off right there and it makes my legs wide and short, just because it cut me off in half right there. That's why I don't like to wear knee-length skirts or anything knee-length, just because of that reason. If you like a shorter skirt, try to get a skirt that is like at least 2 inches above your knee. So that is a complementing look. It's gonna show more legs, therefore it's gonna make your legs look longer. So that's it, you guys. These are all the clothing items that I don't wear anymore or stop wearing just because it doesn't make me feel and look confident. I wanna be empowered when I wear a certain clothing item, and I will feel empowered by my choices. Yes, what you wear can actually boost up your mood and boost up your confidence. It's all about making the right clothing choices that will make you feel confident and feel empowered. You want to wear something that's gonna be able to make you feel and look better about yourself. Especially these times of pandemic, we want to be able to boost up our energy and self-confidence. It is good for our mental health as well. Thanks so much for watching. I hope this video is inspiring to you. Be in the know by subscribing to my channel. If you love fashion, sewing, DIY, and style, be sure to subscribe and hit the notifications so you will get notified whenever I post a new one. I have new videos every week. I post 4 times a week. So that's a lot of video for you guys to enjoy. I will see you next time. Bye!